Morning, guys. Going over my incline here, and as you guys probably already saw on my Instagram post here, and then you're going to see the after this video here, you'll see from beginning to end, I started with 135, but I didn't start videoing until 175 and progressed up 20 pounds until I got to 275 for my pause doubles. So I'm doing this deload, kind of a moderate deload, really. I'm not going incredibly light, as you guys can tell. Pushing myself to a moderate weight like I did with 275 for two. This way, I'm still getting some work, but not so much taxing on my central nervous system. Like I have, achy muscles, tendons, ligaments, whatever, the normal, but being, a little bit more aggressive, I guess, with this program, I have a deeper ache and such, and my central nervous system just needs a little bit more time. So taking a step back, moving back a little bit in weight. So, for example, I hit 315 for four last week. I go 275 for two this week. And you're probably thinking to yourself, okay, that's not really light. But if you look at it from the heavy volume point, 315 for four, and you add up six sets of that, six times four, 24, we'll say moderately heavy to last two sets, very heavy sets. Where I did basically 10 sets of two today, and that's only 20 reps. Okay, so I'm actually down four, but I did more sets and more volume that way, but much lighter. Okay, so that's why I like categorize it as moderate. Either way, regardless. Pushing myself just enough, but not going too far so that I recover well. Definitely feeling good. Do my drop sets from there. Everything was paused. I was really focusing on the eccentric portion of my lifting just because I need more work on that. With me personally, for the stability, I've always been quite explosive as a lifter, as an athlete, and the concentric portion is pretty good for me. So what I need to focus on is like eccentric portions, which is your controlled descent into any of the lift, and probably some more isometric, if anything. I do little to none. Like planks might be the only thing I'll do that's an iso movement. Well, shouldn't say movement, hold. Either way, gonna take the same approach with my squat and my bench. Gonna work up there. I'm gonna be doing my pauses, getting a feel for that weight. And another reason why I want to do that is to make sure that my body is still used, even though, it's only a week off, we'll say, still used to feeling some kind of weight in my hands, on my back, whatever. That way, when I go into these heavy triples and doubles here coming up in the next 2 weeks, I'll be able to basically walk right in, no problem, central nervous system hopefully feeling good, weights are feeling light and they move well, technique's on point, and I'm feeling stable. That's the big thing. So that's where I'm leaning. Definitely enjoying my progress right now. Obviously training as raw as possible. Gonna continue to do so. Hopefully here, in the next 2 weeks, I'll be able to reach some more PR territory, because I'm knocking on door. I had a couple PRs so far, but we're moving into some lifetime PRs, and I'm gonna want more, obviously. Just gotta stay smart, and I think the biggest thing for me, it's not necessarily the training, it is my rest and my recovery. So am I eating properly? Am I sleeping enough to get the rest? I do the active recovery. I do the training. That's not a hard thing for me to get into the gym. I think the hardest part is dieting and rest. I think it's so easy to, miss out on a meal or eat something bad or go to bed late and have to wake up early. So, gotta make sure I'm on point with that. I mean, I've noticed, especially over the holidays here, just eating and drinking a little bit more. I'm out of whack. I'm out of my routine and everything. So it's like I need to get back into that routine. I need to get back into a good regimen, sleep-wise, food-wise, and all of that will snowball into my training, and hopefully I will progress to where I want to be. If not, maybe more. If not, maybe less. We don't know. It's, we have an idea. I have enough experience now to have a good idea of where I want to be and where I'm heading. But, you know, still, we just don't know, you know, like I can, you know, walk in and they'll say slip on ice. I can slip on ice and hurt my knee, hurt my back, whatever, you know, we just don't know what's going to happen. But all you can do is prepare, you know, hope for the best, plan for the worst. I'm not saying plan for slipping on ice, whatever, but regardless, you know, staying planned, staying focused, and staying motivated and driven. I know that's not a hard thing for me either, and for you guys out there listening to this right now, you know, still looking for maybe some motivation, some drive, something to get you into the gym. And I, you know, repeating this from previous videos and posts that I've had out there, you know, there's no fancy programming, there's no fancy training partners, groups, whatever, that are going to motivate you. If you don't truly want to come in here by yourself, then you just aren't motivated enough. You do not want it. You think about it, you kind of want it, but you don't actually want it. You know, using myself as an example, I come in, I train by myself basically every single day except for Sundays. We got our group going and everything. And it's not a problem for me to come in and get after it, get what I need done, and push myself. If anything, I have to pull myself back a little bit and make sure I don't push myself too hard. But that's because I want it. I'm very hungry. I'm very driven. And when I have a goal in mind, I want to reach that goal. You know, like if with any means possible, just to get after it and to achieve it. And I mean, that's in any aspect of my life. If anyone knows me, when I say I'm going to do something, I'll actually go out and do it. So, you know, big difference between your thinkers and your doers and everything. Definitely be a doer. Easier said than done. Don't get me wrong. It's so much easier said than done. Because, you know, I even wake up days where I'm sore, I'm tired, I'm hungry. I'm like, I don't want to do this. It's difficult. But, you know, those are my best days. Those are my best training days, are the ones that are the hardest for me to get in here, get motivated, get training. Might not be with weight on the bar. It's the mental aspect of it. I mentally got stronger that day. I got a little bit sharper. And I was able to push myself, step out of that comfort zone, where we'll say being comfortable was laying in bed underneath the covers, nice and warm and toasty or whatever, and sleeping in. That, my friends, is what it's going to take for you to reach the next level and to be the best version of yourself. Once again, easier said than done. But that's what you got to do. That's what we all have to do. Regardless, if you guys don't already follow me on Instagram, it's at Paul Yeoman, all one word. Please follow the gym as well, at the_basement_gym. And then please subscribe to this YouTube channel here, The Basement Gym. If you guys have any questions for me, or if there's content you guys want to see, please feel free to comment, message me. It'll definitely help me actually get more stuff out there, knowing what people want to hear more of. I know a lot of people like to say they like to see the big lifts, even though I'm not like lifting huge weights, you know. But whatever it takes to make it maybe a little bit more exciting, a little bit more viewable, clickable, whatever, okay? But either way, you guys, thanks for watching. Please reach out. I'll be talking to you later.